Hi everybody, this is Peter Virag here. It's been a while since my last upload. In this video, I'm gonna focus on 100 of my favorite macro shots that I took in the last 12 to 16 months. I spent about 3 hours going through the folders this morning on my computer, and hopefully you'll like the selection that I got. Before we jump into that, I'm gonna briefly talk about my setup. My go-to setup or go-to camera is the Canon ATD APS-C sensor. The reason why I prefer to use this to my 1DX to full frame camera, because this one is actually lighter, so it's much more portable. You can get into smaller places or more confined spaces, and also gives you a little bit more detail, higher megapixel count, 24 megapixels. The 1.6 crop factor comes into play as well, so it gives a little bit more detail. The lens that I use is the 100mm macro lens with image stabilization. I also use a Speedlite, which is the 600EX2RT. Gives you perfect results in most instances, highly customizable. I also attach, I always have this on just to soften the light, the bounce diffuser. And to further diffuse the light or soften the light, I also use the, the Lastolite Ezybounce Card, which is really, really practical. I can show you in a second. You can just fold it out like that and then just change, you know, the direction of light and then customize it really, really efficiently. The other option that I have, sometimes I use a constant light source, which is a Lumecube. I have actually two, so I can set up different configurations. And with certain insects, highly iridescent insects with, you know, beautiful transparent wings, sometimes the flash can cause issues if you don't use diffusers or special boxes like light boxes, which I don't have access to. So I use this instead. Very customizable. You can change the settings. There are 10 intensity settings as well. So that's what I usually use. Most of the shots that I will show you in this video were taken with the ATD, with a couple of exceptions. I took some of the shots, for example, a couple of dragonfly shots or a telephoto shot of a bee, which was taken with my 100 to 400 millimeter telephoto lens on the 1DX2. So that's about it, about the technical side of it. Let's have a look at the images.